She wasn't afraid of anyone, not even herself. I'm gonna miss her so much. Thank you all very much for sharing this with us. I hope somebody's hungry because we got a lot of food. There's
tell me something. It's not going very well with Frankie, is it?
No.
Okay.
I'm scared to death, although I try not to let her see that.
There has to be something that I could do.
Well, as a matter of fact, there might be, but I just don't have time to explain it to you right now. I'll tell you what. Why don't you give Ryan a call and tell him that I said that you're part of the team?
All right, of course I will.
Well, we'd better hit the road, honey.
Good. Dean said that he's going to drop by tonight for a full update on our day in court.
I hope you can give him a good one.
I do.
So do I. Good luck.
Bye. Bye. I love you.
Coming.
Okay. Rachel.
Good luck.
Bye. Thanks for being here.
You bet.
Good luck.
Rachel, we really do have to talk. I just don't know quite where to start.
Just say it.
I'm afraid to. I think the answer might be no.
We'll be more private in here.
Rachel. I would like to re-sign with Corey Publishing.
I never dared hope for that.
Does that mean yes?
Of course it does. Did you think I would say no?
Well, I wouldn't blame you. I mean, after all, I put you through so much.
Honey, you've been struggling with so much. A disease.
I've been hateful.
Yeah, but you're not now, and that's what's important.
Well, I'm still on pretty shaky ground, but I am fighting it, and I intend to keep on fighting it. One day at a time.
I believe in you.
Rachel, I want so much to be there for you now.
Oh, excuse us. Sorry.
Why don't I go see him if he needs any help, okay?
Okay.
Hey, we were thinking about going over to Paradise. I've got a lot of fond memories of Ada there.
Yeah, I think a lot of us do. Nancy wants to see her.
Is that okay?
Sure. I gave the keys to Lorna. She's probably still there. She'll let you in.
Thank you.
Have to go check.
Listen, I know we're both really bummed out about Ada.
I'd like to stay here a little while longer, if it's okay.
It's okay. How would you like to have dinner, just the two of us? We could go have some Mexican food and reminisce about one of the only people that was really pulling for us.
Thank you. I'd really like that.
Then it's a date. See you at home. I love you.
I love you. Well, I wanted to remember Ada here, you know, where we could talk.
I close my eyes and I can hear her giving me advice. I remember this one time that I snuck up behind her.
Ah!
May I have a word with you, Mrs. Hobson?
Happy birthday.
Jake, how... Thanks, Jake. You're cute, you know? You're really cute. But if you think I'm gonna get Hannah out of your hair, you can take your flowers back.
Why do you always think the worst of me?
Experience.
Pauline and I just got back together. We need a little privacy, Ada. We are in love.
Jake, love is not all cuddles and cooing. If you really care about Paulina, you'll be there for her. You'll help her with this thing. Grow up, Jake.
Yeah, I owe that lady a lot.
Me too. She taught me that I was hiding from myself.
And she gave me a job when nobody else in this town would touch me. I'd have given up on a lot of my dreams if it wasn't for her.
You know, I always wanted to do something really spectacular for her. Now I don't have the chance.
I don't know about that. Seeing you and me happy, doing what we want to do, that's what you care about, that and being loyal.
I'm loyal.
Your boyfriend isn't. I think even Ada would tell you flat out that Kevin has given Frankie a raw deal.
And I think Ada would tell you flat out that Kevin is your family and you should stop giving him so much grief.
Yeah, well, don't you think he should lay off Frankie? I mean, it wasn't that long ago that he was in her sneakers. I wonder what made him forget that.
Yeah, Ada always seemed indestructible to me, too.
And never more than a phone call away. Who am I going to call now?
I'd like it if you call me, ma'am.
Why do I feel like I've lost my best friend?
You were only supposed to give up the books, not the entire restaurant.
Why is this hitting me like this? I've been through tough times before.
Tell me about it. Like when I was a teenager, nothing could be worse than that.
You were full of surprises. But I wasn't worn out then.
Mom.
It's how I feel.
We all feel like that from time to time.
You're too young.
Oh, don't tell me I'm too young. Everybody calls me ma'am in stores. I look around to see who they're talking to, and it's me.
That is a tough one.
And then there's Allie. She's made me a grandmother.
She's made me a great-grandmother. I'm not ready to get old yet, Rachel.
Who is?
The thought of being helpless and having you take care of me? It enrages me.
If anything happened to you, I would want to take care of you. And besides, that's a long way off as far as I'm concerned.
Well, it feels a little too close to handle.
Once upon a time, there was a woman who told me never to give in to my fears. And that the only time she would really be mad at me was if I gave up.
She had a big mouth.
I thought she was pretty wise. She also told me that life was a great adventure. And that death was just another beginning.
I didn't think you were listening.
Show us, Mom. You were as important and necessary to this family now as you ever were when I was a kid. Please don't even think of giving up.
Interesting group. Three sisters and nothing alike.
No, I guess they're not.
Kind of like you, Iris, and Amanda.
Paulina, get in here right away.
Rachel, what is it?
What's the problem, Mrs. Corey?
Oh, my God. Look, somebody's not only broken into my desk, but they smashed the lock.
This is Bob Ward. If you and your family like to drink apple cider, there's a warning you should know about today. Health experts say some ciders can contain deadly bacteria. For the story, stay with 10, Southern New England's leading news station. Okay.